In this video, we're going to work on getting some new biomes into our game, and I'm also going to show you a small update that I did to the character sprite that I'm using. I just think that the new sprites I'm using are going to allow us to expand on the game with resource gathering a little bit more than the current sprites that we were using. So let me cover the new character first. So this is the new sprite sheet. I will link again in the description, but here is our new character. So let me go to our animations and let me show you what this guy looks like. So he actually doesn't have a separate sprite for the sword. We're just going to use all of these in one motion. So let me just show you what he looks like here. I'll bring him up in our game just so you can see him. Very similar style. I have all the animations set up along with our attack. But the good thing about this asset is that we are going to have inside of the player actions. We can't really see this. Let me open this up real quick. So this new asset sheet, if you can see it, is going to have a pickaxe. We're going to have a regular axe, and then we're going to have a watering can and the stone axe. So we're going to be able to expand our game to be able to chop trees, mine rocks, and just further allow us to have more flexibility with the features that we're going to build in this game. So I'd suggest for you all to use the new assets and see if you can update it yourself. The only stuff I had to change in the script is I had to account for the hitbox to also be flipping horizontally when we move left to right. So I do have some flipping going on here for the sprites, and then I also have a hitbox scale X, so -1 for when we're looking left and +1 for when we're looking right. So if you can't figure out how to get this working, let me know in the comments if there's anything confusing, or feel free to check out the GitHub repository link to just see what the code is like. Outside of that, I really just wanted to do a quick look at us to build some more levels. I know the last couple videos have been very, very code heavy, so I wanted us to just be able to make some more levels and biomes. So right now we just have our cave, house, and our main test level here. I went ahead and made a desert level, which you can see right here. I also made a desert cave. What I want to do next is we're going to go across this bridge over here and we're going to make the tundra level. So you can make as many levels or different biomes as you want. They don't have to look like mine. But let's just go through the process again of creating new levels and working with scene transitions and things of that nature. So in order to even get to this level, we do need to make sure that you have the scene transition set up here. And then we're also going to need spawn points. You're going to need several spawn points here. We're going to have the next spawn point name, the next level. So I have the desert level here, which points to here. And then I have the from desert cave and the desert spawn. So the desert spawn is my more or less my default. And then I also have the transitions from the desert bridge to go back to the test level. And then we have the desert cave transition here. So I can show you what this looks like right now. Let's talk to our guy, Lil John, have him move, walk here. And then we can go into the desert cave, which for me is basically the same thing as our test level cave, except I gave it the lava instead of water. So if all that was a little bit unfamiliar, we're going to do the same stuff for this bridge here so we can go set this up. But I think for now, let's actually just go start building a level. So let's make a new level. I'm going to make a new 2D scene here. I'm going to call this the tundra level. And we need to assign our level script to it. We have a test level script just because we were specifically handling slimes there, as well as the bridge guard and the cave blocker. So we don't really need a custom script for that right now. But what we will need is a node, a regular node, which we're going to call tile maps. And let's add a tile map layer. Go through the tile set creation process here, and let's go up to our assets. And under environment, we can find the tundra. And for the bottom, I'm going to use the tundra path. And which else do we want to use here? We'll also have the, not the tundra resources. We're going to do the tundra ice and just tundra here. So we're not going to select those. We need to go make sure that these are going to be animated. So let's go into our setup. And we need to select all the tiles that we're going to use. So all of these above the animations can be fine. And then we just select all of these here on the bottom left. Select all of these tiles. I think I got a comment from someone in one of my videos that this is an easy way to set up all of these animations when we select them all at once. Now I can go to the animation. We're going to go to the frames. And there should be four on the X value for separation. And then we can just slide all those over there. Do 0.2 across the board for all of these. Now we should have our animation set up. Let's also just save this level. So an important part is, So let's rename our tile map layer to ground. And then we also want to go in and add it to our main tile map group. So let's go in and animate this tundra ice one. We're actually not going to need the tundra path. That's going to be our ground objects. So let's just get this set up first. And we go into our setup here. We just have to re-grab all of these. And we are going to animate all of these. Except for those. Those shouldn't need to be animated. And then we have how many on the X? Looks like 7. I guess it's 6. Okay. Okay, and we can do these as 0.2. Alright, so now we have the base setup here. Let's start building some stuff here. Okay. We're gonna do the bridge after. Let's just get the base set up right now. All right, so I'm just gonna get this white and let's just make a big rectangle for us here just to get the base of the level. I think I want to use the ice. Yeah, I kind of like the idea of the ice being here. So let's see what we can do with this ice stuff. Cool. Yeah, I think I'm going to have that as my edge here. Again, we can continue to expand on this as much as we want down the road. Just kind of want to make a small little level for us just to change up the way that this is looking. Okay, the wrong one's over here. Yeah, looks a little bit nicer. This one, that one. Okay. Yeah, let's go back to our tile set here and let's add the ice down here. All we're going to do is just select this one here. I just want to have the base ice tile. So let's select this. I want it to be animated also. So let's go. How much separation do we have? Should be 4. 0.2 across the board. Let's save that and we can go back and actually start placing this on our tile map now. So I'm going to make this, that is a line. I want the square. Okay, again, you don't have to make this as big if you don't want to. I'm just going to have this here, give us some more ability to expand on this down the road if we want. Sweet. Okay, so let's get the bridge that will actually place here. So let's add another tile map layer. I think I've been calling this ground objects. And let's go into our tile map here. We need to go back into the inspector and create a new tile set. I'm going to re-add the ice, igloo, tundra path, tundra bridge. Basically all of these, it's just going to be things that we can pop on the ground. I'm not going to, I'll do the auto select since we are going to need some animations here. We can start with the ice here first. We just need these. We've already done this right here. So let's go to select all these tiles again. It should be separation 4. Okay, and I'm just going to take a look at all of these, and I'm going to fast forward or speed this up a little bit quicker just so you can see what I'm doing. But let's just start doing all the rest of the other animations here, and I will see you when we're back at normal speed. So now we're back. Let's see what some of this stuff looks like. Let's maybe try and place an igloo here. Nice. Honestly, I don't even know if I like how much of this is ice. It's really distracting. So I think we're going to try and build, I'm gonna erase a lot of this, I think. I don't know how you guys feel, but it's really distracting, I think. We can expand on this as we want. I need to be on the ground tile. But making my eyes hurt a little bit. Yeah, I don't think I like that at all. That's super, super distracting. We are going to go back and just do the regular old water here. So I'm going to speed up through this again. Sorry, I can't deal with this. Let me just do this really, really quickly. All right, it's a little easier on the eyes here. If you want to do the ice, you definitely can, but I'm thinking I'm going to keep that off at least for now. Okay. All right. So let's put the bridge on here. Where's the bridge? Ground objects. Let's do the bridge. I need to make this animated real quick. Okay. So let's make the bridge now. We can finally go back to our tile map here, and we're going to need over here. That there. We can build this out a little bit. Then we need to go to this bridge here. Get all of this. That looks good. Here. And then boom. Okay, so before we just do any other design stuff, let's just get this set up with our other nodes. So we're going to need a regular node here. Let's just duplicate this. The first one is going to be our spawn points, and the next one is going to be our transitions. And let's add a spawn point here so we can go down. We are going to go to our character folder, get a character spawn, pop that right here. We're going to call this tundra spawns, our default. Pop that in our spawn point. And then we need a level transition. Could be in our transitions. Let's add a collision shape to this. We're going to give it a rectangle. Whoa, not that big. I want this to be over here. And this is going to be, if we run into this, we will go to another level. So the next level path will be, we're going to go back, for me, it's going to be the desert level. If you didn't make the desert level, you could make this, go back to the test level, whichever you want. I'm going to go to levels, go to the desert level, let me save this. The spawn point here is going to need to be created. So let's create a character spawn. I'll put that right here, put it in the right folder. I'm going to name this from tundra. And then we need another level transition, which can be right here. The next level path will be our levels. We go to our tundra level. The next spawn point will be our tundra spawn. Let's give it a collision shape of a rectangle. Let's save that. There we go. All right, so now we can test this out and at least make sure that everything is all cleaned up. We definitely want to put this in our level transition in our tundra for where we're going to go next at the spawn point. So let's just play this out. So none of this should be changed. Little John moves. I come to the desert. Now when I walk all the way over to our next bridge, I must have some collision shapes. Okay, so I had a tile underneath here. That was actually the collision layer was bleeding through. Okay, so here we are. Now we're in the tundra, so we can build this out a little bit more. All right, so I think for the rest of this video, I'm just gonna fast forward through. I'm just gonna build out the rest of this level. Feel free to stick around, see what I got. If not, feel free to also join the Discord. Show me what you guys are working on. And sorry, the content has been a little slow. I was dealing with some computer issues and other things, but in the next video, we're gonna pick back up into our inventory system, because now that we have a sprite that can chop trees or mine rocks, I want us to be able to have the full backpack set up, and then we can also start creating some chests that will populate loot for us and continue that way.